The honor of the largest spider in Florida goes to the incomparable golden silk orb weaver. These spiders have long bodies and even longer legs, characterized by alternating brown, black, and yellow bands. Their bodies are yellow and can grow up to 3 inches long, but golden silk spiders have legs that can reach up to 5 inches across. If you want to purposely find and observe this amazing spider, the biggest web-spinning spider in Florida, and the U.S. for that matter, your best bet is to get up early on a foggy, dewy morning and head to the brushy woodlands, swamps, or wetlands. Every one of the millions of spider webs can be seen in the dew on such mornings. At the edge of a brushy swamp, I find the classic huge, dense web of a golden silk weaver covered in dew. But it appears nobody is home. The spider may be holding in a shelter under a large leaf at the edge of the web. Nearby, a second large web is occupied by a golden silk weaver, and if you look close, the tiny male spider can be seen sharing the web. He'll eventually end up as a light snack for the female when his duty is fulfilled. This female spider is facing bottom out and is on the back side of the web to us and not doing much. A little further on, I find a beautiful specimen of the golden silk orb weaver glistening with dew in the early morning sun. She is going to fix up her web from overnight damage, so we will get to see this gentle giant in action. Again, we see her partner, a tiny male spider about a quarter of an inch long, nearby. This is one of the greatest examples of extreme sexual dimorphism, or the systematic difference in form between individuals of different sexes in the same species, within the natural world. Golden orb weavers are relatively common in the southeast United States, where they like to build their webs across little-used hiking trails or animal trails in the bush, about 5 to 7 feet off the ground. They are hard to see later in the day when the dew dries, and to walk into one of their webs face first is a mentally traumatic experience one will never forget. Although they are slow and unlikely to bite, and if they did, it wouldn't be much more than a bee sting. Spiders are a good reason to let someone else break trail on a group hike. These incredible spiders prey mostly on flying insects like mosquitoes, flies, moths, dragonflies, wasps, and bees. Let's just relax and watch this amazing spider tend to her web making. Now, if you ever wonder the lengths I go to get videos for you guys on the channel, I spent 45 minutes with this spider right beside an alligator and cottonmouth infested swamp. You can't imagine just how miserable it is out in there. But this swamp of scrub trees and scrub bushes and things like that, that's real dense. Great for nesting birds and for these big spiders. This beautiful spider just fixed up the web for the day. Big alligator came right up here a little while ago. I was filming, but I couldn't interrupt my filming. And he went away. Surprisingly though, the mosquitoes are not bad. The other occupational hazard I forgot to mention, besides the alligators and the cottonmouths, is these invasive fire ant mounds out here. Heaven forbid if you should ever accidentally set your foot in one while you're taking a video or something, because it would be ugly. Actually, I'll kick it for you. And there they be. You do not want to find yourself standing on one of those. Nasty. Probably worse than an alligator. Anyway, that's the story behind the story. Give you an idea what it looks like out here. You got to keep your eye out where you are. Backyard birding out.